Very exciting news coming from Softr that they now have a brand new action that you can take inside of buttons that are pushed in your web application. So this is going to allow us to trigger webhooks inside of Softr. And if you're a little bit intimidated by the sound of that, don't be, because in this video, I'm gonna be breaking it down for you step by step, how you can use this powerful new feature to revolutionize the way you work in your no-code app. If that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools. In this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be jumping into Softr's brand new feature, the ability to take webhook actions with our button pushes. Now, before we get going, I want to encourage you to follow along with me. If you don't already have a Softr account, please go ahead and use our affiliate link. It's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. But if you do already have your account, excellent. Go ahead and open it up and follow along with us here. Now, we're gonna hop on into an older application that I used as an example. And the reason for this is I need to make sure to walk through the process of updating our blocks. So the first thing that you might do is just go into any application that you've used before and click into a block where you have a button. Now here I am inside of this hero type block. And if I scroll down to the buttons, you'll notice that if I look at the actions for these buttons, I don't have that new change. So first and foremost, I need to start with the fact that in order for us to have this kind of functionality, we have to be in specific types of blocks. So depending on the block type that you're using, you may or may not have this functionality. So for me, I'm gonna be doing this from a list block in order to get the action that I am desiring for our output here. And so in order to get there, I'm gonna flip over. Again, this is just an example application, but I'm gonna go over to a list page that was built by default. And here we're gonna see my little list added here, and it's not currently looking to anything because it's not properly mapped to any bases. So the first thing we need to do is make sure to update this block. In the bottom right corner of my screen, you'll see that it says block update available. Let's click on the details here. You can see it's been a while since I activated this particular block. It's got HubSpot as a data source. This announcement came out a few weeks ago. The new action here of triggering a webhook from our button push, that's what we need. And then lastly, we can also add the download file action. You should be doing this periodically inside of Softr already. If you aren't, this is how you're going to unlock the new things, the new features that Softr releases, and make sure they're available for your application. So I'm gonna click update now. We're gonna sit back. It takes just a minute, not long at all. Now that we've uploaded the block, we have to map it to our base. Now, you may already have your block mapped, but this is a brand new example. And I've already set up a little test for us here in Airtable with three different fields. First field is a name field. Second field is a picture. Third field is an email address. So let's go ahead and imagine a scenario where we have a list block that looks at the different records of contacts in our database. So I'm gonna first map it to that base. It's called Webhook Staff Example, and I find it just by searching the list of different databases in Airtable, and now I map to my table, staff. Now I can also pick a view. In our case, I won't. Softr is gonna think a little bit in the background while it loads the information from that table, and you can see that it's already brought in the names. So here on my live view here, you can see the names of the people getting brought in. But the next place for me to go, of course, is to map my content. Again, you may have already done this in your case, but I do not need a project lead. In fact, I want to say email instead. So let's relabel this and map it to the email. So this is mapping to the email field inside of Airtable, whereas this name is mapping to the name field inside of Airtable. And then lastly, I will map to the picture inside of Airtable. Let's go ahead and bring that in as well. Make sure that we are linked up, and we are. So now we should be good to go. Now we don't have this data currently visible on our list because it's not showing here. So we have to click show. And now we're going to see what we expect. This is pulling in the data from Airtable, the photo, the name and the email address and putting it in this list block here. So great. So far, so good. We're looking pretty good. But now, my friend, it's time to get into the button. We're going to flip over to actions. And you can see right now we already have a button present. This is the update button, and it's set up by default to allow us to edit this record. So we can change this action step to take some other action if we'd like, or in our case, we're gonna add a new button. So I'm gonna add a new button and scroll on down here, and now we're gonna find the brand new action of triggering a webhook. I'll make this selection, and now we're gonna have a new button, a second button, added to our blocks. So if we were to click on this little ellipse right here, we're gonna find that second button, assuming that the update button is available. In this case, I'm just gonna delete the update button since we don't have a need for it, and here we can clearly see the new button that we just created. So we have to fill out some information for this button, and it really depends on what the webhook is that you're trying to tie up to and trying to accomplish something with. So for our example, let's imagine we want to initiate some form of automation using a third-party automation tool. In our example, I will use make.com to create a webhook that when the button is pushed, it will receive the information from our Softr application. So let's get into how to do that. First, we need to go into make and build a new scenario. Here, I'm going to add a new application called webhook. So that's gonna be the trigger for this automation. Give make just a moment to think, and then we can select webhook from the list here. And we're going to create a custom webhook, and we are going to add a brand new hook. So I will name this new hook example, or new example for Softr. And now I'm going to just save this up. Now, make is giving us this webhook. It's made this URL right here. And you can think of this as an address. We are going to send information to this. It's almost like a phone number. We're gonna send information here when the button's pushed, but we're gonna tag along some extra information as well. Let's take a look at how. So I'm gonna copy this to the clipboard, and I'm going to back out of here and say okay, and now go back to Softr. So inside of my webhook URL, I will paste that webhook that I just copied from make. Note that if you're using Zapier, the steps are going to be practically the same. Create the webhook and copy it in here. Now we have to choose the method of this webhook. Are we posting information, or are we doing something a little bit more complicated? For our example here, we are going to be posting this data from our Softr application and sending it to make, so we keep it on post. Now we can add a little bit more stuff to this webhook. We could use URL parameters, but this is not my preference because Softr has made it so easy for us. We can actually break this down and use the header or body. So for our example, because we're using make and a post method, we're going to use the body, and we can identify as many keys as we want here inside of here. So we have three different pieces of information that we might want to send along to the automation. So for example, we might want to send the name. Well, how would we do that? We identify this key of name, and then we have to provide a value for the name. And when we open this up, you can see the access to all the information we have. Now for us, we're taking this from the staff record. So in this case, I'm pushing it for this individual or this individual. And so if I want to pass along information from that record, then I have to bring it from the selected record. So I can bring in the name from the selected record in the staff table and send that information to make, and it will be received when the webhook is received. I can also, though, you may have noticed, add other values as well. So I have access to URL parameters inside of Softr. I have access to the page URL inside of Softr, and I also have access to the logged in user. So whoever's logged in and pushing the button, I can use their information. So if I have a logged in user who needs to receive an email after they push a button, I can do that with this webhook action right here. I can send their email to the webhook. For our example, we're just gonna send information that is from that staff record. So I'm gonna go back to that selected record, and I can send the picture as well. So let's send the photo, You can name the value whatever you want. The important part is you will use that value to break out that piece of information and use it in subsequent steps after the webhook has been triggered. Now, lastly, I might bring in that email. So I'll bring in the email address here and again, map to the selected record in the staff and bring in email. I can also set up my webhook success message. So after the button's pushed, what are we gonna receive? All right, now that I've set up this button, let's give her a test. I'm gonna publish the changes here to my web application. And I'm going to preview my application. So we're gonna let this load in the background. This is now going to be a live version of our application with the new button that we just set up. It's gonna take just a second, and now we see the three different staff records and the ability to trigger the webhook. Now remember, the webhook, when we push the button, is gonna send this information to Make. Now if you wanna see what Make is gonna receive, I'm gonna flip over to Make right now, right click on my webhook and say run this module only. So it's waiting, it's out there in the ether, it's waiting for us to send it a message. So back in our preview, I'm gonna hit trigger webhook. Now note that I triggered it for Mickey, so I'm gonna send Mickey's name, Mickey's email, Mickey's image that is tied to his staff record. So back here inside of Make, if I look at the payload that I received, I can open this up and see all of the information. So remember, we identified these different variables, photo, email, and name, and you can see that they were received right here. Now, because the photo is an attachment and it's treated as an array, it's a little messier. Now, in terms of the email and the name, it's just receiving text, so it's a little bit easier, but we can still map to the array of items that we receive in the photo. And if we were to look at this URL right here and open this in a new window, you're gonna see the URL that Airtable created for us temporarily while we were activating and sharing that image. So there you have it. A lot of potential open now to you with this new webhook action. You can send, initiate automations from inside of your Softr application. And of course, the thing that I did not mention is your ability to hide this element inside of Softr. So here is my webhook here, my webhook button. I can absolutely come in and change the visibility of this button so that only certain people inside of my application can access it. All users, logged in users, non-logged in users, managers only, clients only, whatever you want inside of Softr, you can slice it up how you need. That's it for this video. Leave any questions you have wherever you found it. And in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.